And Jones is closing the gap for Felix, it looks like. Has closed the gap, but Felix ran it on. He's within 1 second to come back up to three. It's all about 49's little bit of meters right now. 25 meters is actually a huge gap out on him. He's going to close it now, but I don't think he's going to see his boys again as they come over this little time. It's going to be extremely important at this moment right here. When they hit this, this maybe 2.5 is important, but I think the next section, this little kicker here, depending on how hard these boys go over it, is really going to determine whether or not Felix is going to see them again. If he can outdo them and watch the kill them right now, he most likely will be able to go with him, but Peter here is not holding anything back and is going to cause him to go over the top of here at 25 miles per hour. We are seeing Felix here only at 22. The gap is going to go away, and I don't believe he is going to see them again because just 5 to 15 meters, it obviously wasn't within 1, 2, or 3. So Felix in no man's land here. Maybe they will slow down at the bottom of the climb, but Vision would have two in the lead group at that point. I don't think Peter wants to see that. Jones goes to go to the front. Chomp here trying to slow things down a little bit. Just seeing it on the back here, seeing his Peter is right there. And holy K, hey now, there we go. So, we're going to 3.6 watts per kilogram, 161 beats per minute. From Mr. Henry trying to get back. Now we just see Aaron Curry here, 1 second over, and it looks like he caps with DJ Alfonso here, 2.8 watts per kilogram, leaving out the main chase group out on the court. I have no idea why somebody just heard this for a moment. Once in a while, that has happened. There's just all kinds of competition going here. Clock to be in the race to be in the next one. And the rest of you is going to take off 2.4 miles, but I'm not sure that I'm going to get in there. I'm going to be right, but this isn't going inside. I'm aiming to Toto, but I'm not sure that I'm going to get in there. I'm going to be right, but this isn't going inside. I'm aiming to win the beach map has Chris is saying, clap to be headed to open. I believe you folks that may not know how to handle that. It should be that bad from a people are choosing a race and see that the man of course on the race is nasty. So, I'm sorry, not nasty. I think that's Johnny. And so, this might be not the go to the other side of the race with Amazon.com. I just Google it. And I think he's talking about connecting your Amazon account with your Twitch account. I think that you can post it right in your settings actually. Setup and Drift with Swift, anything like that, you can go right on into the broadcast with our social media integration. Love to have your comments for giving it to your real life setups. Always cool to see. you go through the race. The initial breaks have happened. We'll head on over to ZipCar.com. You can actually see the live racing over on ZipCar.com, as well as you can see well, the live racing results, as well as the live racing right here on the broadcast, on the live chat. So the people in the live chat, we've got ZipCar.com, it does bring up all the races in their current positions about, and then there's a little live video chat like Felix, as we said, was not going to see them again. We're seeing him here in no man's land. Beaches, LA's teammate, Jay, actually said he's back. And, well, kind of power-ups are not allowed in the credit card sharing, series. And e-bike is allowed though. So it is slightly gamified, as you can jump onto any bike you want. So TT bikes are allowed, is the point there. A little bit faster than the draft area, but they do not want the power-ups. So power-ups are good, like in Mario Kart, when you run over the little question mark boxes, when you run over the little, those little prize boxes, and the little tick through went down in the upper left-hand corner. Well, if you're watching my avatar, you would see where that hidden course is right above you there. There'd actually be a little spot where my power-up would be if I went through a start finish, a KOM, or a sprint banner. It would cycle through all the power-ups if I were one on one based on random numbers game, rolling up the dice, and those power-ups can be used in order to go faster in different kinds of ways, or draft in different kinds of ways. But in this race event that you're seeing right now, the final year of Party Criteria, they have been turned off, actually, in order to keep things a little bit more realistic. They want to keep the energy out of the game. Some races don't want to include them fully, as they are available to all of the racers. Pierce is now on the attack now. Looks like 178 D-Spinner now dropping to 3.5. Watch the program here, so then jump back into that 5.6 or so. Atwell coming right along, and Tremont now 4.2. We are seeing Jones, who did close the gap up over the top of the climb, now getting dropped off again here on lap number 2, second time up over the top of the Watopia forward here. No hurry monger after the three runners are most likely to go first. Let me see here really quick. All riders are asked to call it on travel here. Tremont in the B category is getting away here and getting a free ride a little bit here with some of these A boys. And with the watch the program, currently the 4.2 from Kaczynski, 4.0 from Atwell, Jones sitting there in South 4.0, but we are seeing Tremont at 3.4 really being a savvy rider right here, putting out way less watch the program, but able to follow all of the moves. So he's been resting up for those key points and then throwing down that dynamic power over the climb to hang on, almost a full off the kilogram less actually than Sosinski as they make their way around the course. Very, very smart riding here coming from Mr. Tremont in order to get the get into this breakaway. And Elijah saying that was a hassle, but all looks good. The main field has gone up the hill and the B has gone flat. Thank you so much, guys, for the commentary and the update. That's not gear as travel loading, so we have way to go. What's going on here? Yen's speed resonance is like, there's one line count as both a race recovery and as a race rep. There's one of the best comments of the day coming from your speed resonance. And tired legs from yesterday and racing tomorrow in 12 hours. The comments from the written in response is even better. It says, I can't gear as travel loading, so yeah, why not? That should have made from the same sources there for those sugars, but we are seeing Jonathan Novick here also bringing in a nice little kick here, saying time to power up the Primal Europe Friday night trip on TFC at 6 p.m. Not too much though, like this guy did. Who is this guy? Definitely want to watch out for him. Don't want to be making any cranks or pedals out there. Where did he find that picture? Oh boy, the team bus is definitely getting me into some trouble, it looks like. Kaczynski now 3.1 left the program with Atwell and Tremont still off the front. Jones here almost chased him back down with 11 seconds there, but I don't think he's going to be able to do it this time. And now the question is going to be, can they hold off the Fondo with Kaczynski, Winsberg? What happened to Felix? It looks looks like he maybe threw in the towel for the day. Or perhaps we are just not loading the riders between, because there was definitely a few riders in between here that were a lot closer. And there's Felix. And I didn't think that they would have pulled out. With Kerr and Felix here now got together, it looks like Rob Fairchild chasing down as well. We might have a vision TTT on our hands with Aaron Cox joining the party in just a little bit here. We'll see if that happens. But 214 is the gap between the vision riders here and the front runners in the race. Jones still 16 seconds off the back. He's probably going to be thinking a whole lot about Kerr and Hemsley as they work together to chase down that 206 on the day. Going into their third lap. They got about 2.5 laps total left to go out today. And Bergman saying, I never said I had science to prove it. In that, I trust the definition is saying about the wine comments there and the beer comments for the recoveries today. Comments as Nathan Garrett should probably point. It's specifically 3D accelerated window. Point out that it's specifically 3D accelerated. Wait, what's going on here? Let me see here. Real quick. Maybe there's a bug with Windows 10 where Windows can sometimes go into the background. It happens to me sometimes, even watching YouTube and Chrome. So it's not a drift bug. Thank you so much. Appreciate that, Tom. I'm talking about it's specifically 3D accelerated window. Gotcha. So that's really helpful, actually. And we'll see if I can find a way to get rid of the bug. Is there windows up there maybe so that doesn't happen? He brought me to the house and Rodney can see what in there. Rodney said, yes, someone on Twitter and Facebook with the pre-doing CBL World Cup race. You guys want to see who's doing the CBL World Cup race? We should just have that as an input at all times for you guys and gals in the, we don't want to focus too much on that from other races and race series, but that is a big deal, and you can bring that right on in, actually, really quickly, as I have used it as a source before, and while this thing's kind of calm down here just a little bit, let's go ahead and see what's happening with the C categories, because Minsky here has gotten away. Real quick, before we show you the C lineup, we are seeing that Minsky here is riding as a B rider. You're seeing the game, but you're seeing B in Tipeee.com, and it's definitely a 2.4 watch recovery. But within category limits, we do have Winsler, it looks like, along with Stafford and quite a few others. Look at this C category, TFC trend, battling it out with, it looks like, Shields here. He's going to have his hands full, trying to get the better of these TFC boys who are all riding together in this C category. They got a solid 35 seconds over Jake Coplin, who looks to have had a dropout. We'll give him a ride out and see if he can get moving again. But moving forward, actually, we'll keep it on these boys while we bring in the lineup for the men and women. For the women's race over at that CBL World Cup, real quickly, if you haven't seen it already, on June 6th. Rachel Heidi Field, Cassie Baldy, Joe Gailey, Carrie Colbert, Rachel Zambrano, Anonymous Benning, Anthony Crystal, Liz Garrett, and Katrina Weiss. And they will all be doing updates on their social media about their running to the event. You can also click on our events, actually, and we're going to start scheduling events day by day, actually. And here, right now, in the Twitch chat, you should be able to link for you the event for the CBL World Cup, so make sure to head on over there and get your reminder of when we go live. For the men's, we will have two pilots, Peter, Tweedy, Kim Little, Adrian Tumaskever, Richardson, Shane Miller, Yoko Cruiser, Scotty Weiss, Peter Szczesinski, who's at the front of today's A race right now, actually. With Kim Lookins, and also Jeffrey Creel is also going to be there as well coming out of Australia. So back to Peter Szczesinski, actually, as he's attacking into the SEC game. Tremont, they're following very closely with Atwell as well. Looks like Jones was able to keep it within 18 seconds, and this boy's got all day power here at a steady TTF, and we're going to ride on as he tries to chase his boy back on. But Pierce is instantly trying to break things apart at the front of the race. And James Hutchinson still needed to fix typos on those names. That is, all the resources just provided to you, so definitely want to chat Thanks a lot for your practice. And maybe give a little pin over to the thanks a lot for the comment, which is I was about to say. What is the I'm looking for the is that Zinski? Which names are we talking about here, Hodges? I didn't even take a look. So I just kind of just read right on through. Is it Peter? Is it Scotty? I'm looking through here real quickly to see if I can find exactly what person is but now it looks like we do have still, Jones 36 seconds is going out again, so unable to hang on to that steady gap that he was holding on to as the attacks go through the S's that are going to hang into lap 2 today. Lap 3 today, halfway down in the final European. So, Lindsay down. He's dropping off Mr. Jake Kerr, who is about 4 seconds now as they head into the SEs. And not letting up to the teammate, Ruff is there as well with Aaron Cox, and looks like they're not going to be seeing the likes of the other Vision Boys anytime soon. Q-Ruff, your 4.7 watts the kilogram, they're trying to chase things down. A little, putting in a pretty good dig, it looks like here, as Aaron's unable to hang on at that 4.3 or 4.4. As Ruff is definitely turning things a little bit into the time for it, because absolutely did drop on the call very closely. Did drop off, did roll out of the US of A, so this group is going to be getting away for the B and C chasing him. We are seeing Shields along with the Drew Ginsburg stop it. Maybe just going back to them actually. The GS, he knows those boys that were coming on pretty strong and that they were not going to be able to hold them off. Kaplan now wasn't able to get his bike rolling again, it looks like. And I think Kaplan and 2.7 lost the program or so. Maybe be able to hold off Keith, but definitely fell way off the pace of the other C boys. And it looks like the C group here, the main chase, this is starting to break up a little bit here. Winster trying to hang on. Shields there as well, 3 seconds back. Actually, Shields, part of that, was trying to hang on with all those PFC boys, but they definitely working together here and getting away from Shields, who was definitely outnumbered amongst that group. We do have, it looks like, the good end with Kehoe, Beveridge, Winster, Stockford, though, just hanging on. A five-man group in this team time trial now at this point, trying to bring back. DJ Alfonso is falling off pace from Kuzminski just a little bit here. And now Kuzminski turning the pedals just a little stronger there. DJ Alfonso 2.9 lost the field there. Now getting back on towards the finishers. And now 5 seconds back from Ralph, who has gotten a little bit of gap over him. We'll see if he can close on that 53 seconds to the front. But now I see that chase group of those Vision Boys. But now 36 seconds. They're able to keep it steady here, but I think it's going to go out again as they're entering their third time at the front of this race, over the top of the four laps. Hopefully, with Atwell and Elijah from 4.0 laps to go, Krasinski and then Chamber. For the pack results recently, let's go ahead and see what's happening for the front end of the race as far as pack results go. That is the race that we're looking for and that we give Krasinski from Team Home. Looks like Doug has 145 races out onto it. 145 races out onto it. Very experienced, obviously. Field racer, 6 watts to fill the rest of the 2 beats per minute. And that's going to look to be a 322. He won one lap race from the one lap race, looks like yesterday. WBI is got 10th in the 2 field race and the 7th in the UBI year. There's a 4th in the FBI pit. That's all in this past week. Lots of training happening out on the front field. As he's getting ready for his time in coming up in London. Looking through then to Mr. Atwell, though, as we're just seeing rain out there through the camera from our helicopter view. But Mr. Atwell here is dropping off pace, though, in the A-cab, 2.5 watts to kilogram. Atwell has a 9th, a 6th, and last week with the ninth place, and the fifth place for the week before that. Really likes the fifth, actually, as well as the SCR races, it looks like. Jumped into the SCR and Friday 13 are the main races that he does. Wednesdays and Fridays. Going to be Mr. David Atwell's races that he's jumping into. Looks like Truman here, able to follow the wheels there. And let's see where the Washington program had benefits for him. If he's still playing his Fridays, definitely, people who watch the program, or to the field, has a lot of wins in the group category. 67 wins, 10 out of Belgium. And it looks like the seventh team will be Kiss Kettlebell TC Wednesday. Excuse me. 2.72 off the front of the generation of that strength on fourth in the Kiss Ripple to wait for. And back on, it looks like Sunday, he was able to grab a XRS pitch second place on the flat loaders. So solid results recently for Team Fraternal. And all of these guys are limited. And really, it looks like Savvy Flyer out on the grip. And we were talking about that a little bit yesterday. There's definitely a tactic to the racing out on Zwift, and a skill to it. There were some comments about this game takes no skill because you don't have to handle balance, handlebars, and with the handlebars of turning and leaning into crits and corners and, mountain bikers obviously going crazy through all kinds of single track and downhills around the technical sections or out on the track, being able to use the draft and diving into the corners, using, all these different things that you're able to use in a different outside or in real life. Racing out on the bike, but I would argue that it's just not as apparent to individuals that maybe aren't looking at the intricacies of the game, as you're definitely seeing a skill here that Tremont has learned about how to control his avatar with his power stroke. They're just not very used to the skill of a game with an interaction with a virtual world, I think, with using our hands, and so I have a feeling that a lot of people don't read into it that, look, Tremont is using a very good skill at learning how the draft works, how to use the different in-game consistencies or inconsistencies of other riders in order to get the best advantage that he possibly can with giving really good timing and really good drafting techniques, as well as using exact timings, just like you would in real life for cycling with a draft. To use the least amount of power that you possibly can, and then use the most amount of dynamic power at the most important times. As you can see, Tremont now attacking here, actually, 7.3 watts because I'm up over the top of that little climb. Getting the most out of the climb there, making sure that he can put the hurt on Peter just a little bit, or making sure that Peter's not getting away from him here. So at 3.4 watts before, and Peter putting up 4.2 for the duration, there's definitely a lot less energy being expended here from Timothy, with a lot of skill that he's learned over the races that he has done with that 67 races out on Zwift. As we continue to get the rain here and the shots being blocked there from the helicopter view, Tremont sitting on at 2.8 watts per kilogram. There's some questions asking a question there over Twitter saying, Do you have a personal favorite out of the Williams race? Thanks a lot, Kev. We're just going to try and stay unbiased in there. I have a personal favorite. I definitely have a personal favorite person in the races there. I think we even have a lot of them over at our still frame jumping around there in the videos for her avatar there. So I think I have a personal favorite for sure. I think I have a exactly. They have been revised, the creator apologizes for the errors. Thanks a lot, Tyler. We appreciate it very much. Send it on over our way and we'll get those updated for sure. HR came out right. I'm looking here. I see it. We talked to W and then Rachel's name. I was actually looking for Rachel. Jr. Sr. looks like David now 41 seconds off the back here. Jones now 56. Looks like they're going to be hammering out in solo TT efforts. Trying to hang on to these places going into the final lap. They will hold on to them for second, I'm sorry, third and fourth place respectively. As long as they do not get caught by Hennessy and Carroll. I think Hennessy is going to be closing down that 2 minute gap. It looks like they're off in a solo TT here. Not going to be seeing his teammates anytime soon as that 50 second gap has gone out. Looks like Aaron here has been dropped off by a full 1 minute and 11 seconds. It was only 5 seconds up over the top all that time into the S's that last lap, but definitely, as you can see, it is a race of years at all times out on Watopia. So, now B.J. Alfonso here with Kuzminski. He was able to get back to his wheel and hang on up over the top of the time kit. He will now, along with the other Sea Riders, have been chasing these boys all day long. Let's see if they do launch any kind of a serious attack to try and bring Kuzminski back, as he's been trying to hold off this sixth group of riders for the entirety of the race. They've held him within this 30 seconds. It comes down to 5, then back off to 30, goes down to 5, goes back down to 30. So definitely been a crazy race here for Kuzminski to try and hold these boys off as he ends up with the PTZ rider here, B.J. Alfonso, in game. So we'll see if he's able to do this. Let's get the Kuzminski's current off the field on auto course, up in 3.4. Racing as a B, it says in ZipPower.com. He's yet seen his name here, so maybe these boys were just chasing down because of that. We'll have to see. Maybe they have no interest whatsoever. They're just going to battle it out at the front of the C category right now. Currently, Winthrop putting out 2.9 watts per kilogram. Winthrop has gotten the better of all these boys, I think, over and over again. He's got a lot of wins here, it looks like. 2 wins in his last couple of races. So he wins for from the TFC team here. Second place, going for P. Hill. Beveridge has had a third and a second as well in the last couple of races that he does. But I'm looking at Winthrop's past results. For 75 total races. Shields, but oh my goodness. Let's talk about this guy, though. Real quick here, as you know, okay, wins for 75 races total, won last week, won the week before, so definitely has gotten the better of these boys in the C category. But recently, Shields was dropped off over the Essies, actually. There was a solid gap to him, but Shields is riding for Team Young. How many people are on Team Young? How many people look at? A lot of people are on Team Young. So, it's kind of funny because they're none team, but people are actually listed on that team. It's not actually a team, I think it says that they are looking for a team, perhaps. But we are seeing Shields here with a solid 2.8 watts per kilogram, 12th, 5th, and 17th for his races. He's got 83 races out on. His whip match between the FTP, the 8th and the Kiss Europe race on the 23rd 3 days ago, the 21st and the Kiss Sunday Europe race, took a 7th and a 12th then in the Canada Europe Friday break. So definitely a solid ride here for Shields. If you can stay with these boys, this would be one of his best results of all time. 5th place and then a 2nd back around the 8th. So maybe gonna have one of his better results in the C category for 4. Shields here, solid race for him. So we'll see if he can hang on with the front end of this group and get the better of the other TFC riders. But it's going to be a difficult day to do so with so many of these team members working together out here in the C category race to try and break Shields. But there's no love lost between these boys when they head into that final lap. As we've seen, Rinsford drop them off the last 2 weeks and get the W over them in this C category race. Oh gosh, who do I cheer for in the scenes, Chris is saying. Chris, are you going to be cheering for Shields here? Come on, TFC, cheering, Matthew Burton. Michael Collins saying go TFC with a little bit of a fist bump there. So definitely got some TFC crowd cheering you boys on here to see if you get the better Shields here. Shields being the underdog, I think, amongst the boys. 181 beats win. Stockton sitting at 171. You're seeing the Drew here, 168. Winsman here, 147. Definitely has a lot left in the tank here. Just waiting to attack. It looks like Beveridge as well, 148. I think he's going to be two boys to watch out for. He held him out here at 164. Who is still riding for? He's got the TFC kit on. I'm not sure if that's the right for TFC, though. Yeah, he actually does. Definitely has the TFC. But not to the point, it is going to be 12 hills, 16 races out on here. Had a third in the WGR 4 Rapid. second to the time fighting Criterion actually 2 weeks ago. And that would have been the win for us in second place, 2 after Winter. Let's go ahead and see it real quickly. Oh no, I think it's to David Vicente of but let's get back to the front of the race. And these boys are going to be hitting their SEs for the third time. They're going to be starting their hangout. And that guy in that was definitely not on my list whatsoever. Somehow he clicked somebody and ended up at Bruno Vieira, PTZ. Somebody has turned into a woman out on course. I'm assuming maybe wife and some of the other out on course there. Hammered away. Bruno Vieira suddenly turns into a woman out on course. We have the ZZRC coming through here as well. Good to see ZZRC out there. We're going to keep on moving forward and see if we can find Tennessee boys. There we go. I have no clue how we ended up. We've got a couple of things happening today. That was definitely interesting. Felix Envy now here, giving us a good shot into the front of the race. Timothy has gone off the front with Straczynski. Straczynski, there he is. Attacking the S's, I'm assuming. One lap to go. Last time over the 400 Timothy Turmont in the B category is now going to have to settle for second overall, it looks like, as Peter, one of the CBR live events in London participants coming up, is going to be off the front of the footwork by Watch the Golden holding him up. All these solo TTs here at the front of this AB race, as it looks like not a lot of matchups that are going to be consistent for a sprint finish here. So Timothy here all day long is hanging on with that 3.3 Watch the Golden, but Straczynski obviously with a lot more power in the legs as he was able to put up 4.2 watts per kilogram for the duration of the race so far, almost a full watt per kilogram more. Timothy held on for a very long time in order to stay at the front of this course, as well as with some really smart tactics hanging on to those wheels, but too much for too long, and now he's got to hold off Atwell, and Atwell might actually catch him, as Timothy definitely is not putting out the same watts per kilogram. Atwell's got a solid 3.9 for the duration here, and I'm not sure that Timothy's going to be able to hold on to this overall at 2.4 watts per kilogram, fading very quickly at about 4.5 watts per kilogram from the window, 170 beats per wheel. Will Atwell be able to chase him down? David Sherman at 3.8 now, will he be able to kick it into that 4.5 plus that we're seeing here from Turmont now, as he's making into this 3.4 now into that 7, 8, 9, 11, 12% gradient that he's going to be feeling there out on course, 2.4 watts per kilogram. Well, Atwell's got his chance here to close down 17 seconds and take that second place overall from Turmont. They're not racing each other as far as categories, but it definitely matters for the overall here. And I think maybe Turmont a little bit too much too early here, as David is going to show what he's made up here over the top. We'll have to see if he can close this down. Michael Powell is in the broadcast here over on the Facebook. Obviously, I'll be back on the PFC train soon. Good to hear, Michael. Hope to see you out on with new music. It looks like Johnny's in the house giving us a little wave there with a very interesting email. SPK wave. Good to see you. I do like the underdog, but that's my team personally saying to not be chasing the shield, chasing the shield somewhere. None is what null, void, etc. is called in Python. So it's probably a bug problem at the same. And we have 7. What does it mean to go over category limit? Your overall average was more than the category's match stats for the cap. On Zwift.com, I'll give a quick little explanation on the categories. So not just on Zwift.com, but in Zwift. The categories have been set up to be 4.0 watts per kilogram or higher for the A category. So if you jump into a race, if they do not have the categories all set up for you in the race. So like this race had a D and an E category. So there was a D and then there was everybody else, okay? Or if it just has an E category, then you can put A in your name if you know that you can hold 4.0 watts per kilogram or higher for your functional threshold power. You can hold for 1 hour straight. If you don't know your functional threshold power, you do an FTP test to find that, and you get an idea. Or you can use a race for it. A lot of times races are really good if you push yourself in a race all out to figure out what your FTP is as well. For a solid 20 minutes, you can take a look at what you held for a 20 minute or see what place you're at in the race. Do a shorter race though. Don't do a super long race, as you're for the duration of that race, you're definitely going to have a lower FTP registered or a lower max wattage that you're able to hold for that category. But going over category number 10, it's assumed in the A category, when you jump into an E race, when you put A next to your name, like you're seeing Atwell here, that he can hold 4.0 watts per kilogram or more for his functional threshold power. Chermont, as a B rider, is assumed to be able to hold 3.2 to 4.0. And that's so all these categories is so that everyone has somebody to race against around their ability level, right? And so the C category then 2.5 to 3.2, the D category 2.5 watts per kilogram or less. So that's what that's all about. That, and you can jump into sometimes in any one category, so they're all just mass start, but sometimes the categories start separately from each other with a little bit of a time difference so that you don't have situations where categories are drafting off each other and giving an advantage of hanging on with riders that can hold a higher power and tactically they're able to just jump in with those riders and use those riders' stronger power to get away from maybe some other riders who have a stronger dynamic power. So a race like this race, an E category race that everybody's together, but there's still separate categories that they put under their name, might have an advantage to those who have a good dynamic power, like Chermont here. He can sit in, draft really well, but when the rubber hits the road in a VO2 max, 1 minute, 2 minute after, 30 seconds after, he's got some good kick. So that's just a tool in his toolbox. It's really good, but his FTP is still between 3.2 and 4.0, right? And so because he has that good kick, he's got an advantage in an E category race, but he might not have as much of an advantage in a race that has all the categories separated out, where they're all just kind of racing against each other and they can all have a little bit more of a race amongst the B category, where they're no one's able to hold on to some of those trains that might go off the front with the A's or whatever it might be between all the categories. It's just a different kind of race that features and is able to have an advantage on the riders with different kinds of peak power profiles, right? So dynamic, more intense peak power profiles are most likely going to favor those B races, which is totally fine. There isn't one that's better than the other. It's just that's the tools that you bring to the toolbox. Larger riders that have big, huge power profiles for peak powers at very, very short durations, sprinters or track riders, right? So that's great for it. It's just a different kind of discipline and a different kind of race dynamic. We're seeing a lot more comments from you here. Thomas, and I only figured out yesterday that E means everyone. There isn't a fifth even slower category. I had only BCD myself, but there's really a race around the time. Kyle, you're on pretty late. Kiss 100. That's a good one. Definitely, when I was racing last weekend, I had a lot of fun. We're probably going to talk about this on the Zwiftcast, but just a little hint onto this feeling I've had during the races that I've been, I think Simon called it Zwiftified, because I was having the experience in my mental space and in my emotional space of the KISS 100 during my race this past weekend. It helped in this weird mental, emotional way that I've never experienced before, and was able to hang on to moves and just follow any move that went to a race. I ended up winning a pro mountain bike race this past weekend. I would definitely say that the racing out of it influenced my quality of race experience when it came to both the physical ability to follow things, but the mental and emotional ability to stay with things that I had experienced by chasing what I call robots and pixels out on Zwift, running boxing, man. Oh my goodness, with those boys over and over again. Close the gap, Krista, and that's definitely what was happening. And now we are seeing, though, in the race here at Well, I know we got a little distracted, we missed a little bit of a highlight there for David. What a close job closing that gap, actually, right now, speaking of closing the gap here, by Atwell to get back to Chermont. He's already been dropped off as Chermont was able to go with Straczynski, but it looks like Atwell's right back with him, and maybe Chermont's going to have to play some of these smart tactics again to hang on to the wheel here, as Atwell grabs on to a rider who's not a part of the race, actually, right ahead of him here, and Chermont just barely hanging on, 8.6 miles per kilogram, and now 5 meters is the difference, able to grab right back on the wheel, though, and I have a feeling they may be in the team bus, actually, getting a little bit of encouragement. Is Chermont actually, yep, there's definitely a team bus happening here. Those boys definitely have voice communication. Ian, Appleby, John K, Kayla, Quinn Maffei, the director sportif over at the Vision Cycling team, is most likely giving all kinds of direction to Mr. Chermont here to get him to hang on to the wheels here, encouraging him on. But now it is a 1 second gap. Can he close it down here? 3.01 per kilo, 32 miles per hour, 33 now, as he hangs on to the wheel of this guy doing a workout right in front of him. Oh no! Chermont's got to close it down right now before they hit the Essies. Now, Atwell, 182 though, really maxed out at this point. I have a feeling that Chermont's got a little bit more left in the tank, but Atwell able to throw down 2.6, 2.9 here. This is for second place overall today. Can Chermont close it down right now? He's going to have to do it in order to get a little bit of reprieve before the Essies and not have to battle out too much here. But Atwell up in that 180, 181 for Chermont now, closing it down. Looks like it's within 10 meters. Will the meters continue to come down as Atwell hangs on the wheel, simply in workout mode here, 200 meters out. Atwell kicking it again, 4.1 watts per kilo, 27 miles per hour, 29 now. Chermont now 6.3, 6.4 watts per kilo. I'm seeing that Atwell is getting away again. Kicks it one more time. And Will Atwell now goes right around knowing that this boy that's in front of him is not going quite fast enough. It looks like M. Orlov now coming out of a green Russia there is being a part of this race. But Chermont now 2.8 miles per kilo, unable to hang on to that wheel for that second place overall. Straczynski off the front here at 1.8 watts per kilo. They're going to be scrolling in for the first place win in the A category in the TFC today. Solid, solid race. All the way there. So, yeah, seeing Matthew Burton with a nice little comment there saying that the racing out on Zwift totally helped for the CX season in the same way, not so much in crits. That is not the comment that we're looking for. And let's go ahead and send it over. There it is. Matthew Burton totally helped my CX season in the same way, not so much in crits. So interesting to say that it didn't help in crits. Maybe probably because of the punchiness, I would say, that comes through crits that you don't always see over and over and over again very quickly. And so for myself, I use racing for one kind of fitness a lot of times, like you were saying. Now, here's the thing though, there are some courses that have been opened up, I think, out on Zwift, like the crit course on the volcano. And I think that is a little bit punchier that might actually help in crits. As far as the punchiness goes of an effort over and over and over again, I think you have to jump into certain kinds of courses to get the experience, though, that you need for those kinds of races. At the same time, though, I would suggest more of a 15 by 15 microbursts or some sort of a anaerobic repetitions, you know, much shorter, much punchier. Jumps over and over again on the minute, every minute, so 5 to 10 minutes. I mean, those are obviously, obviously though too, using intervals over, not over racing, but more than racing out into it is what I would suggest, and then using the races to kind of throw in that leg confusion that comes with racing a bike in real life as well as on the platform like this. So it looks like you're going to bring it in for first place out on course today. And Chermont's saying, I think that's Chermont PBR and Chermont saying, oh, I got nothing left. I'm not able to close it down to Atwell here. Straczynski now, it looks like, going to be taking first place, crossing the line. We'll give him a ride on. Solid effort there from Straczynski. 14th hole in there, first place in the A category in the final year of Friday Criterium. Atwell now closing, closing out the race here, second place. In the A category, Chermont able to hold on though to the win in the. I don't know, Jones. Look at this guy. timeout 47. Look at how quickly this gap is being closed. 46. This boy's coming out at 22 miles per hour. You're seeing 21 or so. Jones now 23 as he gets into 25, 26, 27. It's coming out pretty quickly here. Timeout literally has nothing left. And he strolls in at 1.8. Jones might be able to do something here, but we're going to have to see a kick like none before from Jones here. And he's actually more of that TT all day long. Somebody needs to check their positioning here, since Mansky is saying. What does that mean? we are seeing here Termite now 1.1 miles per kilogram. Jones, I guess it seems to be racing in the role for a game here. So Mansky is saying, great pacing, David. I see David Avalon is saying that, so got it. I was like, what is he talking about? But now I'm seeing the comment there. Great pacing with the cue right there. See, I see the chat there now. I see exactly what we're talking about. Termont, what is happening here? Is he just trying to make it interesting? Oh, I'm just going to give us a little show. 10 watts per kilogram. That's what that's all about. 12 watts per kilogram here. 1,000-plus watts from Termont. What an effort there. And able to get across the line before Jones. And getting a little kick. Jones going to come across the line here in the B category for second place. Behind Termont and fourth overall on the day. Now no love loss between the Vision riders. Kerr sitting in. Going to get the better of Hemsley, maybe. We'll have to see. At 1.6 watts per kilogram, Kerr sits in here. Will Hemsley be able to hold him off? He's leading it out into the negative gradient on the downhill here. This is the place where the boy in the back here is definitely going to be getting the better of the drafting and saving and reserving, as well as the speed, and see if he can come around at the last second here over the other Vision Cycling member here. But it is an A and B category difference, so maybe not going to matter. Kerr, though, maybe going to get the sprinting. We'll have to see who's got the bigger waters, or maybe they're just going to cross the line this order as teammates. More of a holding hand situation, I have to say. Yeah, you could take that from Runway Smith. I have no idea what you're talking about, though. But so ever, I was really interested. Hemsley now with 13 watts. What is that? 1,300 watts. Hemsley with quite the sprint turn across the line. Solid effort there all around. Let's go ahead and see if we can move back and find these boys in that C category, though, as they're making their way here up this year. About 2.5 up from those boys, getting the solo TTV line here with a solid 10 seconds over. Intercontinental with Tuzminski with the BJ Alfonso. It's going to be a battle right to the line between these boys. We'll keep our eyes on them as I don't think they're going to get there. He does have a solid 4.6 watts per kilogram, 11 seconds on the Gold Road Power Rangers. So now, though, Tuzminski here. With BJ Alfonso sitting on the wheel, BJ does have a pretty good kick to the line. And just following that wheel as they make their way through the second half of the NC Sphere. Solid result for the boys to see if he's going to win at the battle here. You know, two line between them. What I meant was great pacing David Atwell. He's going to mess up with the competition in the field. Okay, so he's going to do a nice job out there today, able to do as well as ways. So, BJ Alfonso 2.8 watts per kilogram. Looks like it's Kuzminski here 4.1 hanging onto the wheel. BJ now sitting back in. Kuzminski's got 182 between BJ Alfonso 174, both of them. Pretty high heart rate so far. We'll see who's going to get the better of the other. Anthony sprints to the line here today. As Kuzminski has 2.0, they just keep trading spots here. It looks like over and over again. Waiting for the other to take the pole at the front now, it looks like. 173 though from BJ. Kuzminski now resting up definitely as his heart rate has dropped about 5 beats coming into the tunnel as they hit this downhill section. BJ leading out 2.3 or so. Who's going to kick first? It's usually whoever kicks with the highest wattage at the bottom of this hill. Sometimes it does change up, but they do not have the continuous all the way to the line. We get the helicopter shot here. We do see BJ leading things out now. Kuzminski now coming around, maybe, as he speeds up in the draft here. 4.3 watts per kilogram. BJ still ramping it up. 3.8. It looks like it may be VJT that line to Winsky. Now here comes the wattages going to Winsky though, as they make their way through the 300 meters to go. Now BJ Alfonso starting to ramp up 6.4, 11 watts per kilogram. Kuzminski tries to follow. He's up and out of the 7, 9 watts per kilogram. Tries to hold on the wheel. Does not get the wheel though. And if he doesn't have more than 9 watts per kilogram to give right now, I don't think we're going to see him come around at the finish line. Nope, Kuzminski fades there before they even hit it. And it will be BJ Alfonso who gets the jump first. Kuzminski can hit it for the other side. Now we do have Winsper and the others in that C category. About to come into the finish line. Winsper, as we were saying, had a lot left to get. Stockman was able to follow the wheel. That's a little surprising to me. If Stockman follows all the way to the line here, he's got the biggest kick, I think, amongst these three at the front. It will be Pino, Stockman, and Winsper. Maybe Pino with one of the best races, though, to date here. 6.6 watts per kilogram on this last flattening out point of the course here. 300 meters to go. This is for the win in the C category as they make their way to the line here. Winsper, 5.1 watts per kilogram. Here goes Pino, though, now. 13 watts per kilogram with 200 meters to go. Stockman, though, kicks it into 11. He'll jump maybe a little too early. Fades to 4.0. Will Stockman be able to go close it down right now? It's now or never. He'll grab 12 watts per kilogram to give it. Stockman, come on. No, it will be Pino. Followed by Stockman. And then Winsper with the win the last 2 weeks. We're not going to happen today. As Hill steals it from him, followed by Stockman. And then Winsper across the line in that TFC track. Now we got Bedrue here with Shields here. Trying to get the better of a few of these TFC boys in here before off the back. And the 121 definitely fell off from the pace. Shields were definitely worked over there by these boys. And it's going to be beaten to the line by Bedrue as well. Solid results all around for those TFC boys. And Shields now crossing the line. I think the fifth place for the C category of the garbage for the as well. About 125 to the as we watch Andy make his way to the finish, we're going to go over the C, the A, B, C, D category results with these boys. I finished already for sure. We do have Peter Zinski with the win. David Avalon and Felix Hensley. That's your top three in the A category. Timothy Turner, Robert Jones, and John Kerr for the top three in the B category. Timothy Turner, and Robert Jones for the overall third and fourth, just so everybody knows. Paul Gill, followed by Carl. Well, and Stockman can give the win for the top three in the C category. They've been in the A Shield. They're working that special order for the top five. In the D category, I believe I'm going to be able to bring it up really quickly as we did 2 laps on the flat course. We will be able, I think, have some results. A lot of upgrades. We need to be running this out there. Jackson Jackson, push me up. All rank upgrades in the D category. So Mike Montrose, followed by Jonathan Miller, and then Raha Baski. Richard Taylor and Kenneth Walker in the D category. That's your top five. So nice job to all those D category guys today. So solid effort all around, everybody. Let's see, do we have any? Let's just take a quick look here and see if anybody else is making a way to run. We don't want to miss anybody that might be rounding things out. Kaplan, who fell off the back, but he gave him a ride on earlier. Keats now coming to the line. Martin Leeds as well. We give them some ride ons as they make their way to the line. Solid results all around, though. And the air conditioner in the back. Solid results all around, everybody. Great job. I believe tonight we do have Zuskana with her weekly workout. She will be streaming tonight. I believe we're doing an event scheduled on a different live. Make sure to be watching out for that. If you're on Twitch right now, you can click on events above us, and I should link that right now. So here is events. Click on events up there, and you can get a reminder every time that we go live. We'll be sharing those events on our Facebook, our Twitter, all over the place, so that you can get a reminder every time that we will go live. Obviously, if you already follow us here, you also get those reminders for you to push on to help for you to know every time that we go live. Carissa, thanks a lot for the, I think Carissa just gave us a little cheer. Thanks a lot for the cheer there. I really appreciate the 100 bits there that you just threw out. And remember, if you do cheer, any of the bits will go toward a community effort, some sort of community effort, either a community giveaway, or maybe some of our CBR World Cup. Dota 2 International prize pool boosting sometime for the World Cup. That's a pretty far readout, but just so you guys know, if you do use bits and cheer, that goes to a Zwift Community Live as specific PayPal account that just sits, and it will go toward the community giveaways, or I am also thinking about real life in real life events for the riders too. So thanks a lot everybody for tuning in. Great job to all the racers as always. And thanks a lot to the Cavalier for sponsoring the Friday Car Challenge as well. We'll see you guys later tonight for some workout mode. Let's subscribe. If you haven't done so already, the best place to get notifications anytime that we go live is over on our Twitch or YouTube channel. Twitch.tv/YouTube Live or Mixer.com/YouTube Live. Cheers, everybody.